लाभाय कर्मकिं तन्न कथ्यते किं दम्पतिमिति ब्रूयाम् उदाहो दम्पती इति. द देवास् हेव् गान् टु द हिरण्यगर्भलोक एण्ड् वि सा हौ दे हर्ड् द वेदघोषं फ्रम् अफार् एण्ड् वि स्टाप्ड् वित् दट् श्लोक एय्त् श्लोक. वाग्देवी वदनारविन्द गलित ब्रह्मोद्य विद्याशत ग्रन्थग्रन्थि विभेद जात कुतुक ब्रह्मर्षि हर्षस्तवैः कर्णाभ्यर्नगतैः निवृत्त निखिल क्लेशा दिगीशास्तदा निर्ववृः न च ववृः अव्रणमपि स्वर्गं पुनर्गाहितुं. दे डिड् नाट् फील् लैक् गोयिङ्ग् टु स्वर्ग बिकास् आफ् द अट्मास्फियर् इन् विच् दे वर् नियर् द ब्रह्मलोकम्. Now, the description of that Hiranyagarbha Bhavanam starts here. So, Apicha Adrakshuhu, can you read a couple of Visheshanas at a time?
Apicha Adrakshuhu, Avidura Eva, Te Nirastara, Nirasta Rajasta, रजस्तमो व्यतिकरतया निर्मल सत्त्वप्रकाश राशिमिव निष्कलंक शशांकेष्टका संघटितमिव निरंतर ज्वलत् ज्वलत् अभिन्धन ज्वाला परिवर्त पिंडित दुग्ध सागर सागर सागरोन सागरोर्मि
सागरोर्मि निर्मितमिव
सागरोर्मि निर्मितमिव.
We'll stop with that. Let's look at that. So, अपि च अद्राक्षुः अद्राक्षुः देवाः अद्राक्षुः दे सा अविदूरे एव फ्रम् द फ्रम् फार् आफ् इट् सेल्फ् दे सा द भवनं विच् वास् सी एस् यु अप्रोच् ओन्ली यु विल् नो द डीटेल्स्. सो फस्ट् यु ओन्ली सी द इट् इस् एस् इफ् इट् इस् बीन् मेड् आफ् इट् इस् मेड् आफ् वैट् स्टोन्स् एण्ड् सो हि इस् गिविङ्ग् अ लाट् आफ् उत्प्रेक्षा फार् हौ इट् कुड् हव् बीन् इट् वास् लुकिङ्ग् लैक्. So, nirastha rajastamo vyatikarataya nirmala sattva prakasha rashimiva bhavanam adrakshuhu. So, they saw as if it was made of nirmala sattva prakasha rashi, as if it was made of a heap of nirmala sattvam. Nirmala sattvam, why he mentions that is, see, sattva, rajas and tamas are triguna, and those trigunas have been combined in different forms to, in the srishti krama, they combine in different forms to bring about the srishti of different things. So, sattva pradhanam, if you say, then it means it also has rajas and tamas in smaller quantities. Raja pradhanam will be, it has sattva and tamas in smaller quantities. Whereas, nirmala sattva means there is no mixture of rajas and tamas. So, nirastha rajas tamo vyatikarataya. व्यतिकर सम्बन्धः रजसः तमसः च सम्बन्धः निरस्तः. सो देर् इस् नो टच् आर् द मिक्सिङ्ग् आफ् ए रजस् आर् तमस् बिकास् आफ् देट् निर्मलसत्त्वप्रकाशराशिम् इव बिकास् इट् वास् वेरि वैट् इन् कलर् इट् वास् एस् इफ् द सत्त्वगुण प्रकाशं वास् हीप्ड् देर् इट् वास् फौण्ड् इन् अ हीप्. नेक्स्ट् निष्कल Nishkalanka Shashanka. It was as if it was made with bricks of moon. So Ishtaka, Ishtaka means brick. Ishtaka Sangha Sanghatitam Iva. Sanghatitam as if it was constructed by Ishtaka Sangham by a group of bricks made from Nishkalanka Shashanka. Shashanka, the moon without any the Kalanka, without that blemish. It was as if it was made by blemishless moon. Then nirantara abindana jwalat, nirantara jwalat abindana jwala parivarta pindita dugdha sagara urmi nirmitam. Again, maybe, you know, the dugdha sagaram urmi, the waves of that dugdha sagara, they were solidified because, you know, there is the Vadavanala, which is constantly burning there inside the ocean, inside that milk ocean. So abindana jwala, ab indanam, apyeva indanam yasya saha tadrishaha agnihi. So abindana jwala, tasya agnehe jwala bihi parivarta pindita. Parivarta means paritaha, it is present around. So because of the presence of that vadavanala, which is constantly burning, nirantara jwalatu, which is constantly burning, abindana jwala, that vadavanala, vadavagni, which is found under the ocean, tasya jwala bihi, with that jwala, it is pinditam. It's as if that milk, the waves have been solidified, pindikrataha urmayaha, taihi nirmitam iva, bhavanam. It's all an adjective to the bhavana. Okay, so nirantara jwalatu abindana jwala parivarta pindita dugdhormi nirmitam iva. Next.
Chira nipata ghani bhuta sharada
shirashchandra
sharada shirashchandra chandrika vikirinna
nihara
sara sadhi sadhitamiva traivikrama charana krama vidhi vidyanda
avidha vidyanda
avidha vidyanda kapala nirgala nirargalat alaka nanda nipata
We'll stop with that. So, chira nipata ghani bhuta sharada shira. So, next he, another utpreksha here. Imagine Shakti who is there. So, sharada can be interpreted in many ways. One is Shakti, Saraswati, or Sharat Chandra. So Sharada Shiras Chandra is actually Sharat Kala. The other reading is actually, he says Sharat Chandra. We doesn't use it as Sharada Chandra or Sharat Chandra. There is no Shiras there. But it's fine. Sharada, we can take it as Saraswati. Shakti, who is in the form of Saraswati. So the Chandra, the moon that is there on her shiras, there is Chandrika that comes from that, the moonlight that comes from that moon, and it spreads Nihara, it spreads the Kiranam. Nihara is, snow or that cool rays, and that Nihara Sara Sadhitam Iva, as if the essence of those cool rays have been collected together and it has been formed. That is, the moment you look at that Bhavanam, there is a prasadata that spreads in your mind. There is a clarity that comes to your mind. You have to imagine it. Nobody has gone there and seen. In Tamil we say, Kandavar Vindilai, Vindavar Kandilai. The one who speaks about it has not seen it. The one who has seen it cannot speak about it. We say this expression for Brahma Tattva. Those who have seen the Brahma Tattva, don't talk about it. Don't describe it in big words. You can't describe because it is vacham agocharam. He also gives that adjective at the end. He says vacham agocharam. So here you have to imagine the whole thing. Chira nipata ghani bhuta. For a long time, the rays have been falling. Chira nipata, nirnipatat, ghani bhutam. Imagine snowfall which has been falling continuously. Then what happens? It becomes ice. In the East Coast, we know very well how it is, right? So when snow keeps on falling, after a few days, it will just solidify and become ice. So imagine ice blocks, and the building has been built with those ice blocks. So chira nipata ghani bhuta, falling for a long time and it has become solidified. What has become solidified? Sharada shiras chandra chandrika. Shakti has a chandra on her lalatam, on her head. And from that, the chandrika falls. Lalatam lavanya dutivamalam abhati tavayati dvitiyam tanmanye mokuta gatitam chandra shakala. he imagines in Saundarya Lahari, he says, the Lalatam is also Ashtami Chandra Vibhraja Dalika Stala Shobhita. So it is like an Ashtami Chandra. Her Lalatam is like the Chandra crescent moon. It is as if a second moon has been placed on her face. The first moon is the moon itself, which is there on her head as an Alankara. The second one is her Lalata, Lavanya Dyuti. So here Sharada Shiras Chandra Chandrika, Saraswati is there in that bhavanam. Her, she has a Chandra on her head. From that, the Chandrika is Vikirna. It is spreading Nihara everywhere. It is spreading that snow or and that Saram, that essence has been taken. It is Gani Bhutam. It is solidified and it has been used to create this bhavanam, Sadhitam. So it is as if this bhavana has been sadhita, it has been constructed using the sara, the essence of that nihara, the snow, which has been spread from the Sharada Shirashchandra Chandrika, which is ghani bhutam, solidified, because it has been falling for a long time. Chiranipatam. Traivikrama charana akrama avidha. Oh, this expression, this image is so beautiful. See, to wash it, something is clean and beautiful and clear also. So you have to wash it with something. Wash it with water, then it is clean, correct? So the water here is Alakananda. Ganga, he uses the waters of Ganga. It is as if the entire bhavanam has been washed with the waters of Ganga, Alakananda. When did that Alakananda come? Not the Ganges that runs in Prayag and everywhere. He says, when the Trivikrama Charana Akrama Avidha Vidyanda Kapala, the Vidyanda is Brahmanda, the Brahmanda's Kapala, the top portion of this Brahmanda, which is supposed to be like an egg. So the Kapala portion of that Brahmanda was Avidha, it was hit. When was it hit? When Trivikrama Charana, when Vamanavatara, when he, Vishnu took the Vamanavatara and he used his foot to hit that Brahmanda, at that point of time, there was a crack. So Trivikrama Charanena, Charanasya Akramena Avidha Vidyandam, Avidham Vidyandam, Tasya Kapalam, Tataha Nirgatam. Nirargala Nirgalati Alakananda Nipata Dhautam Iva. Nirargala Argalam is stop. Nirargala is unstoppable flow of Alakananda, which is continuously flowing. Nirgalati, Nirgalati Alakananda Nipata Pravahena Dhautam Iva Asti Tadbhavanam. Another aitihasikam which is being alluded here is Vishnupada Chita Devi. She's Parama Pavitra Ganga. You know why? She is very pure because she emanated from the foot of Vishnu. So Vishnupada Chita, that is during the Vamana Avatara. So when Vamana hit that Vidyandam, the Brahmanda, from there Ganga started flowing in an unstoppable manner. Nirargala Nirgalat Alakananda. Nipata Dhautamiva. It was as if it was completely washed by the waters of Ganga. Huh? So imagine the purity of it. It has not been flowing for a long time here. It had just started. And with that, the Brahma Bhavanam has been washed. So from the first flow of any water is always very pure. And imagine the purity of this Ganga, which has come from Vishnupada. Trivikrama Charana Akrama Avidha Vidyanda Kapala Nirargala Nirgalata Alakananda Nipata Dhautamiva. Next.
Vimala Bhaswara Prabhava Bhasita Bhasita Nabho Vibhagam Apastaka Apasta Kalanka.
Apasta Kalanka Anushangataya.
Apasta Kalanka Anushangataya Iva Dhumadi Marga Chankrama Pankila Charana Pashu Janana Kramaniyam.
So Vimala Vaswara Jana Anakramaniyam.
Oh, Anakramaniyam.
Vimala Bhaswara Prabhava Bhasita Nabho Vibhagam. The Akasha Pradesham there is Vasitam. It is complete, it is illuminated by the Vimala Bhaswara Prabhava. Vimala Bhaswara is Shukla Bhaswara. In the Vyakhyana, he says it is Shukla Bhaswaram. So there are two things, Bhaswara Shuklam, Abhaswara Shuklam are two things, two types of white color, he says, which is a dull white and a bright white. Here he says it's a very pure white, in the sense it is Shukla. It's a very clear Prakasham that is there, and because of that whiteness, the Akasha also reflects that whiteness of that Bhavanam. So Vimala Bhaswara Prabhavena Bhavanasya Shukla Bhaswarataya Tasya Prabhavena Nabho Vibhagam Bhasitam Vidyate. So this Bhavana, it is as if it is reflecting, the Akasha Pradesham is as if it is reflecting this Prakasha. So it is lighting the Akasha with its pure white rays. Apasta Kalanka Anushangataya Iva Dhumadi Marga Chankramana Pankila Charana Pashujana Anakramaniyam. Now, here, there are two types of paths that are taken by people who, after their maranam. So, what are those two margas? One is the Archiradi Marga, the other is Dhumadi Marga. One is Devayanam, the other is Pitruyanam. If you are a Deva, you take the path of Archihi, which is one type of margam. This is all said in Upanishads and in Shruti. So that is, he is just alluding to all those here. So one is the path adopted by the Devas, the other is the path adopted by the Pitru Devas. The Pitru are the ancestors who take the Dhumadi Marga, which is supposed to be where you keep going up and down, you perform karma and then you go through the Dhuma Marga, you become a Pitru Devata and then you come back through that. To the, this is your cycle of birth and death. Whereas for the Devas, they also go through that cycle, but in a different manner, because they are of a higher status and they have moved to that status. From the Pitras, they have moved to the Deva status. So their Marga is different, which is Archiradi Marga. They follow that Archi is Agni. So they use the Agni Marga for that. And by following the Agni Marga, they can go to the Brahma Lokam, but they still come back to the Swarga. So they go through a different cycle. In order to break through that, they have to do upasanas without any interest in the karma phala. Now here in the Dhuma Marga, if you walk through smoke constantly, then what happens? Your legs are all very dirty. So it is as if, because the some people, these pitriyanaha, pitriyanena ye gacchanti te. So the pitriyanam is actually the margam that you take, which is the Dhumadi Margam. Those Pashu Jana, Pashu in Shaivagama, Pashu and Pati are the two concepts in the world. Pashu is the Jivatma, Pati is the Brahmatma, as far as Shaiva Siddhanta goes. So Pashu does not mean animals here. Pashu Jana means all the Jivatma. It is anakramaniyam, it is inaccessible to all the Jivatmas, because as if their feet are pankilam, it is very muddy by going continuously again and again in the Dhumadi Marga. So Dhumadi Marge Chankramanat Pankila Charanani Yeshante. So Dhumadi Marge, those who keep on walking up and down in that Dhuma Marga, which is the Pitriyanam, because of that, their charanam, their feet have become very dirty. And those Pashujana, by those Jivas, it is anakramaniyam. This Bhavanam, Brahma Bhavanam is anakramaniyam. It is completely inaccessible to them. Why? Because this Bhavanam is apasta kalanka anushangataya. The Bhavanam is devoid of any kalankam. Apasta kalanka anushangataya. It is devoid of any anushanga, sambandha of kalankam. There is no blemish or a bereft of any kalankam in it. Hence, it is inaccessible to such people who are constantly going in the Dhuma Marga. So we saw how the Karmadevas are there in the Swarga, right? So it is for those people that we are talking about. The Brahmalokam, Satyalokam and the Brahma Bhavanam is inaccessible for those people. So Apastha Kalanka Anushangataya Iva Dhuma Adi Marga Chankramana. So if some house is very, neat, then we say, you know, remove your chappals out and come because the chappals are dirty, right? It's like that, you say. Because it's very clean, do not dirty it with your feet. Next one.
Ashesha Bhuvana Sarga Vashesha Sarai Iva Vilakshanaihi Shabdadi Bihi Visheshyaihi Upaskritam Vishayaihi Va Vishayaihi Upaskritam Anushravamayaihi Prakaraihi Abhyudayika Upasana Mayaihi Gopuraihi Atmopasana Mayi Bihi Kakshya Bihi Pranava Mayena Chasthana Mantapena Parishobhitam Nija.
We'll stop with that. So Ashesha Bhuvana Sarga Avashesha Saraihi Iva Vilakshanaihi Shabdaihi Vishayaihi Upaskritam. Upaskritam, it is decorated with a lot of Vishaya. So in that Brahma Bhavanam, there are many different items. He doesn't want to describe the items that are there because he has not seen it. He has to imagine so many things. He has already said that even the items in the Satyaloka cannot be described. Now, how can he describe those that are there in the Bhavanam? So he says, after creating all the different worlds, the 14 different worlds, after creating all those, any remaining items, all those essence are here. Now, if that means they are not found in the world. So which means Vilakshana Shabdadivihi Vishayaihi. So Vilakshanaihi Shabdadivihi, it is completely unique and it cannot be expressed by words. Tadrishaihi Vishayaihi Upaskritam Alankritam. So Ashesha Ashesha Bhuvana Sarga Avashesha Avashishta Saraihi. Correct? Ashesha Bhuvana Sarga, after creating all the worlds, Avashesha Saraihi, by whatever it is remaining, it is as if the Bhavanam is filled with people, filled with things which are remaining after creating the world. So Vilakshanaihi Shabdadibihi, it is decorated with things, Vishayaihi, and by words, unique words, Vilakshanaihi Shabdadibihi, as if these were remained after creating the different worlds. Next is, he's talking about how the Mantapena Shobhitam, many different prakarams are there. Now they have approached nearby, correct? So they were only looking at the prakasham first, which is white. So they tried to describe it in sattva guna pradhanam and all that. Now they have come closer so they can see the different areas in that bhavanam. So there are prakara, gopuram, kakshya, and then there is an asthana mandapam. Just like how a temple is built in the same way. So the first is prakaram. What is the prakaram made of? Anushrava mayaihi prakaraihi. Vedamayaihi prakaraihi. Anushravam anu shruyate iti anusritya shruyante iti anushravaha vedaha tanmayaihi prakaraihi. The outer prakaram is made of Veda. So Vedamayaihi prakaraihi. Next is Gopuram. What are the Gopuras made of? Abhyudayika upasana mayaihi Gopuraihi. Abhyudayikam is Abhyudayam. Brahma Varchas Ityadi Prayojana Sahitam. So Abhyudayikam is Saprayojana Upasana. Saprayojana Upasana meaning sajatiya upasana can also be taken there. So not sajatiya upasana, it is more an upasana that is done with a goal in mind, that is abhyudayikam. Abhyudayam is your goal that you are looking for in any upasana. See, not all upasana says Ishvara Prityartham. We generally start off some japa, something like that, for this good thing should happen, you know, someone should feel better in life. Some sort of a goal is there in the small upasanas that we do. That sort of a upasana forms the gopuram. It cannot be the inner portion. That the, only through that, then you go into the fact, you know, you're... So you start off with a goal in mind, and then you are attracted by the form of that Lord. Then you go into the Atma Upasana. You that Dhara is there in your mind, the Krishna Dhara or Shiva Dhara, something of that Saguna Upasana comes only after that. So the first one is Saprayojana Upasana, then you have the Saguna Upasana, then the Atma Upasana. So Atma Upasana, more than that, is the Pranava Upasana. So here he says Prakaraihi, which is Vedamayaihi, the Karma Kanda Upasana. Then you have the Abhyudayika Upasana, where you have specific goal-oriented Upasana. Abhyudayika Upasana Mayaihi Gopuraihi. Then is the Atma Upasana. Atma Upasana here is again Dharakasha Vidya. That Dharakasha Vidya, and there are yagas which are also prescribed, there are upasanas which are prescribed, where you have the Atma Upasana also, it is still not the moksha swarupam. The ultimate is your pranavamayena asthana mandapena parichopitam. The next is your turiyam. That is where there is no difference between the Brahmatma and the Jivatma. The Pranamamayam is where the Aikyam happens. But at the end, he also says, even here, it is not the Mukti that you are talking about. Even beyond this is the Mukti. Right? We are still in Brahma's Bhavanam. We are still not gone beyond that. Right? So here he says, Pranamamayena Asthana Mandapena Cha Parishobitam. It's just an Utpreksha that he says. You can't say it is made of ratnam and all that. That we have finished in Swarga description. Correct? So, Anushravamayehi, Vedamayehi, Prakarehi, Abhyudayikamayehi, Gopurehi, Atma Upasana Mayibihi, Kakshyabihi. The rooms are all filled with Atma Upasana. Or it is a personification of Atma Upasana. Pranamamayena, Asthana Mandapena. The Asthana Mandapam, where Brahma himself is, that mandapam is of the form of pranavam.
Nija nija karya nivedanavasara pratikshita tattva tat pratikshita pratikshita
tattal loka
tattat loka
pratikshi tattat loka
pratikshi tattat loka lokadhikarika लोकाधिकारी कारित सम्मर्द बहिर्द्वार वितर्दिका भागम आगन
let's finish with this. From the next it is description of each room. So here he says nija nija karya nivedana avasara. So there are a lot of different lokas we saw, right? Says there are 14 different lokas that are there, and in each of those bhuvanam there are officials who have been appointed to do certain works. Each of them have to come and report to Brahma. That is their work. Now here they have all assembled at the bahir dwara vitardika bhagam. Bahirdwara, at the outer, at the doorstep, there is a Vitardika. Vitardika is like a mandapam. If you see, before you enter the main temple, there will be a mandapam where actually the Utsavamurti will come out of the temple and they will keep the Utsavamurti in that mandapam. That is called a Vitardika. It is in the outer courtyard, there is a mandapam. That is a vitardika. So bahir dware sthita vitardika, vitardikayaha bhagam. So in that courtyard where there is a mandapam, there all these adhikaris are creating a big commotion, sammardham. They have all assembled there. Taihi karita sammardaha. Who are they? Tattalloka adhikari. The officials who are all appointed to come and report their work. So nija 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 karya nivedana avasara pratikshi. They are all waiting for an opportunity to convey their work. You know, I have done this, I have done this, I have done this. They have to come and report to him. So nija nija karya nivedana avasarartham praye pratikshante. Kete tattalloka adhikari taihi karita sammardaha kutra vitardika bhage tadrasha vitardika bhaga yuktam bhavanam. Okay, next is he starts describing each and every room that are there. There are 7 rooms in that bhavanam, and in each place there are different people who are engaging in different activities, and he is describing that.
ఆగంతుక గంధర్వ కిన్నర కిన్నర అప్సరస అప్సరస మారబ్ధ అప్సరసం ఆరబ్ధ ఆరబ్ధ తౌర్యత్రికం మౌఖర్య మౌఖర్య పూరిత ప్రథమ కక్ష్యం.
So the first room is filled with Gandharva. So Agantuka Gandharva, those Gandharvas and all who have come there, who have all come, Gandharva, Kinnara, Apsaras. Those Kinnara, Apsaras and Gandharva who have come, they start this Tauryatrikam. Tauryatrikam is, you must have read it now. Tauryatrika, Gita Vadyatrayam is Tauryatrikam, correct? So the tauryatrikam maukharyam. Maukharyam is mukharasya bhavam, maukharyam. The noisiness that has been created by the nritta, geeta and vadya. So here, if you see, nrittam is apsaras, geetam is kinnara, vadyam is gandharva, played by the gandharva. 3 categories. So each one do one work of the tauryatrikam, the 3 things that are assigned by the natyashastra. So gandharva, kinnara, apsara, samarabdha, those that have been started by them, tauryatrika, maukarya, purita, prathama kaksham. So the first room is completely filled with the sound that comes from the nritta geeta vadyam that is started by gandharva, kinnara and apsaras. Second room.
అనభిసంధి సంధి సంధిం
సంధిమత్
సంధిమత్ కర్మయోగ నిర్మల కర్మ కర్మంది వృంద పరికర్మిత పరికర్మిత ద్వితీయ కక్ష్యం.
ద్వితీయ కక్ష్యం పరికర్మితం, ఇట్ ఇస్ ఫిల్డ్ విత్ కర్మంది వృంద. కర్మంది ఆర్ భిక్షు. దేర్ ఆర్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ సన్యాసిస్ దేర్ who are nirmala, they are all karma yogi, and so they are pure. Why, how have they done, performed their karma? Anabhisandhimat karma yoga, nirmala. There is a, see, they are all sannyasis who have performed their karmas, who have performed their karmas before without any ichha, pale ichha vihaya, icham vihaya. So anabhisandhimat, abhisandha is a palecha. Anabhisandha is without any icha in the pala. So anabhisandhimat karma yogena nirmalaha karmandinaha. The bhikshus who are all very pure because of performing the karma yoga without any interest in the pala, they have all occupied the second room. Third room is darshanas.
Atigahana nyaya sankhya yoga yogadi darshana tattva marsha vyasana karshita kanada kapila patanjali pramukha vidvad
uddama
duhama jalpa katha ghosha ಭೂಷಿತ ತೃತೀಯ ಕಕ್ಷ್ಯಂ.
ಜಲ್ಪ ಕಥಾಘೋಷ ಭೂಷಿತ ತೃತೀಯ ಕಕ್ಷ್ಯಂ. ಸೊ ಕಣಾದ, ಪತಂಜಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಕಪಿಲ, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ತ್ರೀ ದರ್ಶನಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನ್ಯಾಯ, ಸಾಂಖ್ಯ ಅಂಡ್ ಯೋಗ. ದ ತ್ರೀ ದರ್ಶನಸ್, ದ ತ್ರೀ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ದರ್ಶನಸ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟನ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ರೂಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯೂಯಿಂಗ್. And their sound is being there in the third room. So Tritiya Kakshyam, the third room, which is Bhushita, decorated by the Kathagosha, Jalpa Kathagosha, the different talks, the sounds of the talks that they are carrying on. Uddama means Prakata. They are arguing or they are talking in a very great manner. Sreshtham Uddama. Vidvajjana by the scholars, like who are they? Kanada, Kapila and Patanjali, who they have become karshita, they have become very thin because of their arguing constantly about the Sankhya, Yoga and Nyaya Darshana, the tattvas, the principles of these three darshanas, which are very gahanam, ati gahanam, very difficult to understand the deep philosophies of Nyaya, Sankhya and Yoga. Those tattva, those philosophies have been avamarsha. They have constantly analyzed it. And because of that vyasana, because of that time pass, that is their time pass for them. And they have karshita, they've become very thin because of passing their time with these tattvas, philosophy. It's very, very difficult.
Sorry, I was reading the next one. Sorry.
Yeah, read the next one. Yeah, continue.
Ati vichitratara trayi shikharopa ropapaditopa upapaditopasana bheda vasana sanatha muni yutha darshitascharya
Turiyam or Turiyam is the fourth one. Fourth is called Turiyam. So even in Turiya Vidya is Moksha Vidya. When you look at the four different stages of the Jagrat, Swapna and Sushupti, and then there is a Turiyavastha, which is called the Mokshavastha. So Turiyam is always indicative of fourth. Here the fourth room was filled with Ascharyam. Many surprising things were shown by the Vedantins. So you had the three darshanas, he said in the third room. Then the fourth room had the Vedanti or the Uttara Mimamsa people who are talking of the different amazing things that are there in the Upanishad. So Ati Vichitratara Trayi Shikara. Trayi is Veda. Veda's Shikara is Upanishad. Upanishadi Upapadita Upasana Bheda Vasana Sanatha Muni Yutha. The Muni Yutha, the group of Munis who are all there, they were showing different Ascharya information that is there in the Upanishad regarding the Upasana Abheda. So they have performed the different Upasanas that are there in the Upanishad. And that Vasana or that Samskara is there in these Muni Yutha, in these people. They show the different Ascharya Bhushaya that are there in the Vedanta or the Uttara Mimamsa, and that those people are there in the fourth kakshya. So Ati Vichitratara, so Turiya Kakshyam, the fourth room, showed Darshita Ascharyam, was displaying a very surprising thing which was shown by the Muni Yutha, the sages who had Sanatha, who had the Vasana, Samskara, of the different Upasana Abheda, the different Upasanas that have been said in the Upanishads. Trayi Shikara Upapadita Upasana Abheda. Upanishad Bihi Upapadita Upasana Abhedaihi Ya Vasana Taya Sanathaha Muniyutaha. Right? Adi Vichitratara Trayi. The Upanishad itself is Vichitrataram, or the Upasana Bhedam is Vichitrataram. The problem with long samasas is you don't know where you have to connect it. You can connect it to both. This Upanishad is also Vichitrataram. It is very, it has a lot of different things in it. Or you can say the Upasana Bheda, the different types of Upasanas that are being explained there are also Vichitra. Next.
Akka, what is Sanatha there?
Sanatha Sahita. So Vasana Sahita Muni.
Okay.
So they have that samskara. See, they have not only analyzed the Upanishads that are there. Whatever the Upanishad has revealed, that Upasana Bheda, they have performed the different types of Upasanas. Because of that, the samskara is there within them. With that samskara, they have come here to this Brahma Bhavanam, and they are showing the different ascharyam that is there. In that, so when they are talking of that, the Vedanta, the Upanishad, let's say the tattvam that is there in the Upanishad, they are displaying an ascharyam in that fourth kakshya. Okay.
Atirahasya Vaishwanara Daharadi Vidya Parichaya Parichaya Anavadya Anavadya Maharshi Darshita Upasana Prapancha Panchama Kakshyam.
Now, in the earlier one, it was Upanishad. The next one is also Dahara Upasana, and Vaishwanara Upasana is also found in Upanishad only. Here, he just specifies that separately and says, so Adi Rahasyam, because even in that, these two are supposed to be very secretive Upasana. So Adi Rahasya Vaishwanara Daharadi Vidya. This is the Vaishwanara and the Dahara Vidya is the Nachiketa Agni, the Vidya that Nachiketa's got from Yama. So it's supposed to be a very Rahasya Bhutam. So Ati Rahasya Vaishwanara Daharadi Vidya Parichaya, because they know this Dahara Vidya and the Vaishwanara Agni Upasana. Those Maharishis are Anavadya. They have no faults with them. You can remove all your papa if you perform these Vidyas, Upasana. So they show the difference in these Upasanas also. So Taihi Maharshibihi Darshita Upasana Prapancham. Prapancham is world of Upasana. Not exactly world. It is the... they explain the... they explain the different branches of that Upasana also, how it should be done and everything in that Panchama Kakshya. It is very Rahasyam. So they only sit in that Brahma Bhavanam and they discuss these things. Next.
Ati Dura Visrishta Drishtanu Shravi Drishta Anushravika Vishaya
Amisha Riramsa
Amishiva
Amisha Riramsa
Amisha Riramsa Gandha Parama Hamsa Paramahansa Vatamsita Shashta Kakshyam.
The sixth room has Paramahamsa Yatis who are there. Those Paramahamsa Yati do not have even a Gandham, even a little bit, a trace of the Riramsa. Riramsa Rantum Iccha, that they want to enjoy the Bhoga Vastu that is there. So they Atidura Visrishta Drishta Anushravika Vishaya. Anushravika Vishaya, those bhogas that are enjoined in the Swarga, in the Shruti, they don't have even a trace of that. Tadrishaihi Paramahamsa Yatibihi Avatamsita Shashtya Kakshya. The sixth room, Avatamsitam, it is decorated. Avatamsa is actually, Karnavatamsam means you decorate the ear with a earring. It's like a Bhushanam. So Bhushitam. So the sixth room has been Avatamsita. It is filled with, or it is decorated by the Paramahamsa. Paramahamsa are those yatis who do not have even a trace. Gandha, riramsa, gandha, lesham api nasti. What to enjoy the vishaya, which is a amisham, which is like a, there are many meanings to amisha. Amisha means the mamsam. It also means bhoga vastu. So he equates the mamsa as a bhogya vastu. So vishayaha anushravika vishayaha eva amisha athava bhogya vastuni tesham riramsa tatana rantum iccha icchayaha gandaha api na vidyate esham. So atidura visrishtam tadrisha gandaha riramsa gandaha. The trace of wanting to enjoy it has been dura visrishtam. It has left far off by them. So they have let go, or they have forsaken that enjoyment long time back, not presently. They didn't leave it yesterday and come here today. They left it long time ago. So not even a trace of it is there. Generally, why he is talking about that riramsa gandha? Because the bhogam is such a thing that it just goes and stays with us as a samskara. And when we move from one shariram to another, it is not only the atma that moves from one shariram to another. It goes along with 17 different padarthas. You make it into one small potlam, like a small package, and that package goes from one body to another body. So it carries the trace of scent that each and every sense organ has experienced in this janma. That trace is there. That is called your samskara. If even a little bit of that gandham is not there, you should imagine how many janmas they have taken, and they have prepared that soul to give up all those bhoga, and they have come to this position here. Riramsa gandha paramahamsa visrishta riramsa gandha paramahamsa avatamsita shashta kakshi. Seventh.
Ati chaturya paryavasthapita anushrava tatparya paryalochana apanita viparitanvaya shanka kalanka nirankusha kushala janalankrita saptama kakshyam.
This the seventh room was alankrita. It was decorated by kushala jana, experts in analyzing the Vedas. Anushrava tatparya paryalochana. They were great experts in analyzing the import of the Vedas. By what? Apanita viparita anvaya shanka kalanka nirankusha. So they are how do I say this? So much easier in Tamil. Keep thinking. So, Ati Chaturya Paryavasthapita Anushrava Tatparyam. They are very clever. They display their expertise by analyzing the Tatparyam of the Anushrava Veda. So, Anushravena Proktam Tatparyam Tasya Paryalochanena Apanita Viparita Anvaya Shanka. There is no doubt of Anvayam by understanding it in a Viparita manner, in a different manner. So there are many ways to interpret the Vedam, but they have analyzed it in such a manner, and they have removed any doubts that can arise because of understanding it in a different manner, in a Viparita way. So Viparita Anvaya Shanka Kalankam. That Shanka, that doubt is the Kalankam. Tena nirankushaha, because that doubt has been removed, that kalanka has been abanitam, they are nirankusham, they are unstoppable in their understanding. So in their expertise. Okay. So experts who are unstoppable, nirankusha kushala janaha. Why? Because their kalanka of doubt, shanka, what is that shanka? Viparita anvayaha eva shanka. Viparita anvayena ya shanka utpadyate sa shanka eva kalankaha atra tadrisha kalankaha apanitaha yesham. So they have removed that kalankam. And how have they removed it? by analyzing paryalochana, what they have analyzed, anushrava tatparya. That anushrava tatparya has been established in a very clever manner. Ati chaturya paryavasthapita tatparyam. Tatparyasya paryalochanena apanita kalankaha nirankushaha kushalajanaha shashta saptamakakshyam alankurvanti. Next.
Prasankhyana parasanghya
bhrugu angiro vasishtadi.
Bhrugu angiro vasishtadi garishtadhikarika muni mandala mandita sthana mantapam.
Finish it off. Apadam.
Apadam vipadam. Agocharam vacham anashankaniyam anashankaniyam vacham va punah
arvacham
arvacham agamya agamyachara matra sharanaihi asadhya madhvaraihi alabhya alabhyam adhikai rapi tapo vipakaihi duraroham mahadanaihi Duravagaha maha
ahava sahasaihi
asambhavaniyam manasapi swayambhuvam bhavanam.
So swayambhuvam bhavanam adrakshuhu. So that is the bhavanam that they saw. So here prasankhyana para asankhya bhrugu angiro vasishtadi garishta adhikarika munimandala mandita asthana mandapam. So after the kakshya, if you saw, he said prakaram, gopuram, kakshya and then asthana mandapam. So in that asthana mandapam, there are a lot of rishis who are sitting there. So they are, who are they? So bhrugu angiro vasishtadi garishta adhikarika muni. They are all like the saptarishis. So they are in a big position. So in a very honorable position. So Garishta is Guru Garishta, right? Guru, it is the superlative of Guru. So Garishta Adhikarika Muni Mandala Mandita Asthana Mandapam. The Asthana Mandapa was Manditam. It was decorated by the Muni Mandala, the circle of rishis, who were Adhikarika, who are in a position of great position, Garishta Adhikarika, like Bhrigu, Angiro and Vasishta, who were Prasankhyana Paraha. Prasankhyanam is Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. So we looked at all the upasana, saprayojanam, sajati upasana and everything. Now we come to the nirvikalpaka samadhi. So prasankhyana paraha, ittukte brahma paraha, ye munayaha, taihi manditam asthana mandapam. So prasankhyana para, asankhya, no, it should not be asankhya, it should be asankhya, innumerable rishis who were constantly thinking of that brahma swarupam or who are in that nirvikalpaka samadhi. Taihi munibihi manditam asthana mandapam. Next, vipadam apadam. There was no place for vipat or disaster. Vacham agocharam. We could not describe it by words. Arvacham anashankaniyam. It cannot unthinkable. It is unimaginable for adhamaha. So if we cannot imagine it, it means we are all adhamaha. So arvacham. For people who are nichanam, anashankaniyam, you cannot even imagine it. Achara matra sharanaihi agamyam, it's very important. Just mere practice of rituals is, it you cannot attain it by that. It is not at all endorsed by anybody. So achara matra sharanaihi, there should be that... you know, feeling and the bhakti should be there. It should be very important. Just achara ityeva, you cannot keep doing things, karma. So achara matra sharanaihi agamyam. It is not attainable by people who just merely follow traditions. Asadhyam advaraihi. By just doing, performing yagas, you cannot attain it. It is unattainable by yagas. Alabhyam adhikaihi api tapovipakaihi. Tapaha, so chandrayanadi tapaihi, tapovihi api tapovipakaihi. or the as a result of the tapas like Chandrayana, etc., also alabhyam, it is unattainable. Mahadanaihi duraroham, it is duraroham means you cannot, again it can, it is not it is unattainable. Arodham ashakyam, dukkena arodham shakyam, by mahadanam, by great charities also you cannot bhudanam, etc., etc., even godanam, any great danam also will not get you to this position. Duravagaham ahava sahasaihi, ahava yuddham, or yuddha sahasaihi, even by proving your valor in yuddha you cannot attain this. So just like you can attain veera swargam by showing your prowess or valor in yuddham, you cannot do that here. Manasapi asambhavaniyam, something which is cannot be even imagined by the mind. Tadrisham swayambhuvam bhavanam adrakshuh, so brahmanaha bhavanam sadma adrakshuh avidurataha nati dure eva te adrakshuh. Okay, next is how they were treated by the people. So we'll look at this next class.